Hi, it's Chris from IH Motorhomes. So today we've had Trevor and Sue from the Posh Cats in. They've given us a bit of a rundown into their IH, their transition from coach built to van and where they've been and the things that they've done. If you are like Posh Cats, if you like to do video tours, you do vlogs, you know, you like to do where you've been and talk about different places around the UK. So should you like to come and see us, you can come and have a look around the stock we've got, see what we're about. Obviously we're a manufacturer as well. Do get in touch, you are more than welcome. If you contact myself or Josh, the telephone number is 01977 677 118. Obviously we're having this open weekend this weekend, so we're here Saturday and Sunday at the 25th and 26th. So yeah, bring your cameras down, let's come down, have a cup of tea, and we'll have a chat about that. We're joined with Trev and Sue from Posh Cats, so hello. Nice to see them again. You keep popping in to see, which is lovely.
Can't wait to get rid of this.
So how are you getting on?
We're doing well. Yeah, we've had our VW crafter now for what, almost 2.5 years.
Yeah,
which has flown by. Yeah, it really has. It? Yeah,
and 2 weeks in Scotland,
right? Whereabouts did you go in Scotland?
We were on the Moray coast mainly,
right?
And we took a little while getting there, as you do.
Yeah,
and finished up in Edinburgh,
right?
For the Christmas markets.
Oh, very nice. Yeah. Did you spend much?
not enough, apparently.
Really. And then obviously you've made it down to us today.
Yeah.
So you've had a look in the new Iveco. We've done the new layout on the Iveco. And what do you think to that one?
Well, I like the fixed bed.
You like the fixed bed, right?
Yeah. There you go. Straight off the bat.
Yep.
And I think. You've made a van of two halves, particularly with this one. The luxury bedroom in the back, and you've got the front lounge.
Yeah.
Which, you know...
On a van, that's quite unusual.
On a van conversion.
You've got both sides, which is good.
Yeah, van
good garage storage as well.
Yep, good storage, yeah. And the washroom, no compromises there. That's good.
Excellent.
Haven't driven one.
Right, we can like do that shortly if you'd like to do
I'd like
that
to
well.
Do a drive.
We can have a look at that.
Isn't it? Yeah. And I was worried about the big barn doors because we have a rear panel on ours.
Yep.
So we have the boot and the convenience of a little opening window. But I notice in the bedroom, when you open the barn doors, you're just exposing the small window area to the elements.
Yeah. Now that can actually be paneled off as well. So if you did open the doors, if you wanted, you know,
is that right?
The bed's not to be exposed, we can do that as well. So it's quite flexible.
Yeah. But then in summer, you've got the benefit of that, haven't you?
Yeah, so, that's right. Good. Yeah, okay. Something that I think the watchers might be interested in is how did the transition from a coach built to a van conversion go? Did you struggle with anything or did you find it quite easy?
Well, I think we got on okay because we loved the van.
Mm-hmm.
That was the key thing. We knew what the IH van was like. We spent a lot of time sitting in it, looking at it, and with the specification. With your team, but I think it was about 6 months really.
We cut down a lot of stuff that we used to carry that we never used.
Right.
So we just take what we have to, don't we?
And I think it takes
the months we remove stuff that we don't use.
Yeah, we did. I think it takes a little time just to stop and you have to remember to stop and think before you leave home. I've got my man cupboard, and do I really need to take all these extra things?
Yeah.
One can of WD-40, you know, a couple of cloths and so on. You cut right down.
But bearing in mind, you do go away for quite some time, don't
we? We do, yeah. And we vary what we take from trip to trip.
Yeah.
So
we utilize every single space.
We do,
There's a place for everything.
There is.
In our power pack, there's a place that's perfect where
that
sits.
That's right,
yeah.
And before we leave home, we think now, what sort of trip is this? Is it a quick weekend? Is it a longer tour? And what things can we take and what things do we leave behind? So we make sure that we've got everything with us that we need rather than things we're not going to use.
Yeah.
So that's the difference, I think,
from
coach built, whereas you just pile everything in, bikes and all.
Yeah, well, of course.
You know, and...
And dimensionally, van to coach built, have you found that driving the van has been more accessible for places?
Yes, and it's more comfortable.
Right.
The driver's more comfortable with a van conversion because it's one piece.
Sure.
All of the coach builds I've driven have tended to be larger, more difficult to manoeuvre perhaps, and park.
Yeah.
Whereas I know that the VW Crafter, the long wheelbase, is a long van. It's 6.8 metres.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah.
But even so, you can still get it in those tight spots. Sainsbury's car park isn't a problem, whereas with a bigger van, it can be.
Yeah, you're not getting near the doors there, are you?
Width-wise.
We're going on narrow roads, you don't worry so much, do you?
Yeah, we don't want to scratch the paintwork.
No, well, you are narrowing 12 inches down on a coach walk.
Yeah, that's right. Good. And you do notice that inside, in fairness.
Okay.
You know, we have... in the past been able to entertain half a dozen people in a coach built van, mm-hmm. whereas we limit it to four really in this one, in our one, because it's and if it's a nice sunny day, they all sit under the canopy.
Yeah That's the best way, isn't it? Well, that's what it's all about, isn't
yeah,
it?
So
and I think another good question is, how has it changed your life from sort of the daily run of the mill, but yet now you're going out for weeks and months at a time. How has that sort of improved on your lifestyle?
Well, we've increased the number of nights that we go away, mm-hmm. And we don't sit still for 5 minutes. We tend to limit our trips to two or three nights, and then we move on. It gives us time to look around. So if it's somewhere that we want to see more of, we'll stay for four or five nights.
Sure.
But we tend to... to stop, park up, have a good look around, and then move to the next park up. With a caravan or a large motorhome, you tend to be a little bit more static. And as you know, Chris, we had the little white Citigo, the Skoda Citigo that we towed behind our big van. We've kept that,
right.
And we use it behind our IH
right,
van.
So we can still, when you need,
still use the van as a caravan if we want to and go out for the day. So that's the best of both worlds. Yeah.
Great. Okay. Well, what do you think? Are we having one? I'm joking.
Today, maybe not, but certainly it's a future plan. Yeah. I'd love one.
Very good.
I'd love one. I like it enough to buy it. Yeah, for sure.
Good.
So it'll be interesting to see how they go.
Yeah, we'll see. It's having a lot of interest. Obviously, we've done well so far. So still build slots available on these for sort of middle of next year. So. If you're interested in that, come and see us. And what's plans now? Are we heading back down south, or are we?
We're home now for a couple of weeks, and then we'll be going on a little Christmas tour to wish our friends Merry Christmas and all of that.
Very good.
And then hopefully in January we're heading off to Spain.
Great. Wow. So fantastic. And how long are you going to Spain for?
3 or 4 weeks, not sure yet.
Right, just take it, play it by ear, and
we
do what
try
you think.
Not to plan too much detail, because we can change it then, can't we?
Great. Yeah. Right. Well, thanks very much indeed. Thanks, obviously,
thank
you for coming.
Yeah.
Next time we see you, it might be springtime, I suppose.
Yeah.
So enjoy your Christmas.
We won't leave it too long.
Great stuff. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again soon.